deprivation of freedom and the having just what the institution gives to you is the cruelest punishment of all.
After you see some of the things that people have done and you know it's wrong, you have to come forward. You can't keep your mouth shut.
Bless the beast and the children, for in this world they have no voice, they have no choice.
I was at Shambhala one day, and Tembo, you'd stand up, you could put your back to the fence, and Tembo, he put his trunk up on the top of my head. It was an extraordinary sensation.
Welcome to Kat Kramer's Films That Change the World.
Hi, I'm Kat Kramer.
And I'm Lily Tomlin.
We're together at the historic Sunset Gower Studios in Hollywood, which is the home for my screening series, Kat Kramer's Films That Change the World.
And we're here preparing for the next screening in your series, the world premiere of Elephants and Man, A Litany of Tragedy, on January 20th. This film was very, very impactful when I viewed it, and then all the education I've done for myself, trying to learn about elephants just made me more and more committed to the fact that elephants should not be held in captivity. We have a lot of really terrific people on our host committee. Cher, Kathy Griffin,
Alec Baldwin, Robin Williams, Billy Bob Thornton, Ed Begley Jr., Lainey Kazan, James Franco.
There's so many others. We are making progress, and consciousness is continuously being raised. It just takes time and commitment from all of us, and eventually more and more people come on board once they're educated and really see the truth of the issue. So that even around the country already, there have been many, many zoos that have closed their elephant exhibits and sent their elephants to sanctuaries where they can live out as close to a life in the wild as possible.
Thanks to films like Elephants and Man, A Litany of Tragedy, we have an opportunity, all of us, to look at the animal cruelty that we may not want to, but educate ourselves and many different generations about how this has to stop.
And it will.
A few days ago, Lily and I got together with Melia Kaplan, who's the executive producer of Elephants and Man, and she's also the founder and president of A Voice for the Animals Foundation, and the one and only Chris Gallucci, who is the executive director of the Shambhala Reserve and also the president of the Roar Foundation.
Such a good guy.
And we really got a chance to really explore what the movie meant to each one of us and what we hope to accomplish on the 20th.
We're here at Sunset Gower Studios, a historical place, formerly the Columbia lot. And we're mainly here because on January 20th, 2011, yep. Elephants and Man, A Litany of Tragedy is going to have a world premiere, and it's kicking off the season for my series, Kat Kramer's Films That Change the World. And I've just recently been educated just in the last couple years about elephants in captivity, which is really the theme of the film. So we can talk about that in a few minutes, but I just wanted to give Lily a chance to talk about her involvement.
All right, well, I'm happy to. I've been asked by friends of mine to write a letter to free Ruby from the LA Zoo, who was released to a sanctuary up in Northern California. And then we continued a campaign to try to get the freedom of Billy, the lone elephant that was still at the zoo. I just became absolutely deeply involved with the intelligence, the sensitivity, the familial connections, the long, lifelong friendships, how these elephants, how they mourn their dead, and just how deeply emotional they were and developed. Elephants cannot be in captivity. They cannot be in a small urban zoo. And I just began working to try to stop the captivity of elephants, displaying elephants for our supposed enjoyment and how much they suffer day to day. It's emotionally and physically completely debilitating to to those creatures, and they're so sensitive.
So I'm going to talk to Chris over here a little bit, and then we'll get to Melia. I'd like to know what you feel now in light of the Elephants of Asia exhibit that just opened.
I was asked to come here to speak about elephants and man. When I watched that film, it was like watching my parents being murdered. I think everybody that does not know what is going on with elephants in captivity should be made to watch this film.
What I'm hoping from the screening is, as Lily said, that people will become more educated. They will not stand for this. They will write letters. They will speak out. They will tell their neighbors, tell their friends, don't go to zoos that have elephants. Just don't do it. And then, as Tony Cardenas says, elephants don't live in zoos. Elephants die in zoos.
Yeah.
Can you talk a little bit about the exhibit and why, in this particular zoo, it's been such a fight?
$42 million is just the cost of building the exhibit. Now, who pays for the yearly maintenance? The food, the keeper, the medicines, the vet? We, as taxpayers, do. Well, our city's going broke. We're firing police. We're not putting money into our school systems. Why are we putting money into a new elephant exhibit if we can't even give our children a good education, and the cops and firemen are being cut? Why is that happening?
The people who are running these elephant exhibits, they're just not doing the right thing by the elephants. They don't understand the sensitivity, the familial structure, the incredible, incredible amount of feeling that these animals not only have for each other, but have for us. And in my opinion, it's completely abusive, and there's absolutely no excuse for it.
But you shouldn't have animals like the big cats, but particularly the elephants, because they are the world's largest land mammal, and they suffer terribly in captivity. And we just have to re-educate ourselves to the fact that this isn't entertainment. This is really cruelty and abuse. That's what I hope will happen, is that more and more people awake to the issue.
Films raise awareness, educate, and bring a call to action. Films can change the world.
The world they see.